Negative.
We need the word used to and the word didn't used to, right? So those were the phrases we used to talk about as habits. Good, Dianita, thank you. Now we're going to have a short review of that. We're going to practice once again. Here we have some sentences, guys. Help me completing these sentences using any frequency adverb if it's about a present habit, and used to or didn't used to if we're talking about habits from the past, okay? Help me completing these sentences. So the first one, we're going to do it together. Help me with the first. How would it be? The first one, Oscar, help me with number one. How would it be? Look at this. In the first part, we have a was, a past, something from the past. So how would it be? Brian, do you want to help me? Everybody.
Sorry, teacher, can you repeat me the question?
Yes, can you help me completing this? We're going to use used to or usually according to the habit, if it's present or past habit.
Maybe used to.
Okay. So Sam used to panic when there was a storm. Sí, Sam solía tener miedo, asustarse cuando había una tormenta. But nowadays, what happened?
Pero hoy, teacher.
Yes.
Perdón que le interrumpa. Mi compañera dice si es que le puede aceptar que está en la sala de espera.
Solo estaba David Venegas en la sala de espera. No sé si es él.
No, es Pamela Suárez.
En la reunión, Pame.
¿Serio?
Good morning, teacher.
Good morning, Pame. Sí, ahí están, ¿no? So, how would it be if we are talking about habit from the present? Ahora estamos diciendo qué es lo que sí hace él ahora. ¿Cómo diríamos?
Usually to stay.
But now he usually. ¿Qué pasa con este verbo stay? Si estamos hablando en presente.
Realmente la ING.
La S.
ING es continuo.
Stays.
Exacto, solo la S. En el presente, acuérdense que los verbos que se conjugan con he, she, it, aumentamos la S o la ES al final. Ok, so, but nowadays, pero hoy en día, he usually stays, ¿sí? Él generalmente se queda tranquilo, ¿no? Permanece tranquilo, ya no se asusta con las tormentas. He usually stays calm. Good. So, similar to this, we're going to complete the next sentences, ¿ok? Vamos a seguir completando las siguientes oraciones. ¿Cómo nos quedará la número dos? My grandmother.
My mother, my grandmother didn't used to send internet messages.
Good, good. She didn't used to. Don't forget that when we are using the auxiliar, use goes without D. So my grandmother didn't use to send. She didn't used to send internet messages. No solía enviar mensajes de internet con el piolín ahí. Pero ahora, but now, ¿Cómo? Luisito, otra vez.
She usually sends.
Good. She usually sends. No se olviden de la S porque estamos con she, ¿no? Good. She usually sends messages every day. Y ahora ya envía mensajes todos los días. Let's see how it goes with number three. I stay up.
Used to stay.
Good, Luisito. Very good. I used to stay, right? Yo solía quedarme despierto, ¿no? Hasta muy tarde en la noche. But now, pero ahora.
Usually to go. I usually go.
Exactly. Usually go. Ojo, no ocupamos el to para separar, ¿no? Sino que va directamente el verbo. Usually or normally. I usually go to bed at 10 p.m. Sí, usualmente voy a la cama a las 10 de la noche. Okay. So, number four. How would it be? Pame, can you help me with the first part? Ayúdame con la primera parte, Pame Suárez. When John was younger.
He used to like.
Good. Yes. When he was, or when John was younger, he used to like. Le solía gustar el rock, ¿verdad? He used to like rock music. But nowadays, pero hoy en día, what happens? Oscar, what happens nowadays?
He usually prefers this to jazz.
Exactly. Now he usually prefers, with yes at the end, he usually prefers listening to jazz. Good. Let's do two more and then we're done with the practice. Sí, vamos a hacer dos más para no olvidarnos y continuar con la práctica. Help me with number five, please. Carlita Reyes, how would it be?
A ver, teacher, sería Peter, you said to. Right?
Good. Very good. So Peter used to ride his bike after school. ¿Sí? Peter solía manejar su bicicleta después de la escuela. But last year.
Is incorrect. Because Peter usually
ride. Al revés, ¿no? So let's move this one. Good. So how would it be, Dianita?
Peter usually ride.
Good. Peter usually rides. ¿Sí? Peter usualmente maneja su bicicleta después de la escuela, pero el año pasado él solía jugar fútbol, ¿no? He used to play. Acuérdense, cuando encuentren ustedes las time expressions del pasado, ya les están hablando que estamos dirigiéndonos a un hábito del pasado. Good. Thank you, Dianita. Let's complete number six. Evelyn, can you help me with number six, please? Wake up, ladies.
Me escucha.
Yes, I can listen to you.
My parents didn't used to play computer games, but now they usually do that. It's very nice.
Okay, my parents didn't used to play computer games, but now they usually do. No cambiamos aquí por does. Acuérdense que el does sería para he, she, it, ¿no? They usually do it every night. Ahora usualmente juegan todas las noches, ¿no? Good. So, we had a short review about last class grammar. We were talking about how to use this or how to talk about these present habits and past habits, right? With the use of the phrase used to. So let's see what do we have for today, guys. Today, as you know, we will cover unit number, in your case, it's 3C and 3D. So these lessons are mainly going to talk about some phrases we can use when we talk and with some phrases you can use when you write. So today we will be talking or learning a little bit about speaking or useful phrases to speak and some useful phrases also when we write, okay? So let's begin with the first part. We're going to talk about this lesson 3D. Here we have some of the objectives, as I was telling you before. We're going to learn some phrases to react to what people say in the first case when they are telling us a story. And in the second case, you are going to learn some phrases again. In this case, to describe time when you are writing, okay? So we will see what are those phrases and you will have to write also something. This is going to be what we're going to do today. We also, well, at the end, I'm going to ask you or we're going to make a short review about any doubt you have before you go to your midterm exam. So let's begin, guys. Let's begin with lesson 3C, okay? Here we go. First of all, I want you to think about these five questions we have here. We're going to divide them into two groups, okay? So the first group, we're going to think about these three questions. And Lourdes is going to help me reading the questions. Lourdes, help me reading these three questions, please.
A ver, teacher, number one, when was the last time you bought a present for a friend or relative? A ver, number two, what was it? Number three, did they like it?
Okay, awesome. Thank you, Lo. So think about these three questions, guys. When was the last time you bought a present for a friend, a relative, or maybe your boyfriend or girlfend? Okay, think about it. And number two, what was it? What was it? What was the gift? What did you buy? Okay. And number three, we want to know if they like it or they don't like it, the present you bought for them. Okay. So think about this question. Remember the last time you bought something for someone. Alan, help me with your answers.
Hi, teacher.
Hi.
The question number one, last week, good friends' birthday.
Okay, good.
Number two, I have him a basketball.
Okay.
And number three, he liked it very much. He was very happy.
Yes, he liked it. Good. Thank you, Alan. Let's see what happened with Nico. Good morning, Nicolas. Tell us, when was the last time you bought something for somebody?
Good morning, teacher. I think that I bought 2 months ago for my girlfriend. I bought earrings.
Okay.
And a ring. And she loved it.
Good. So Nico has a good taste choosing some gifts.
Thanks.
So thank you so much, Nico. Let's listen now to a lady. Arlette, can you tell us when was the last time you bought something for somebody?
Teacher, repeat again, please.
Sure. Can you help me with the answers of these three questions, please?
The last time I bought a present for my mom,
mm-hmm.
For your birthday.
Okay. Did she like it? ¿Le gustó el regalo?
Yes.
What did like you buy? ¿Qué le compraste? What was it?
I buy flowers, chocolates, teddy.
Okay, a teddy bear. Good. Very romantic was Arlette with her mom.
Yes,
teacher. Don't forget, Arlette. Don't forget. You have good answers, but we need to pay attention on the pronouns. Sí, mucho ojo con los pronombres, Arlette. Que si decimos por ahí y me respondes, I bought to your mother. Sí, I bought a present for your mother. Estás diciendo que compraste un regalo para mi mamá. Sí, mucho ojo con eso. En este caso no sería your mother, sino
my mom.
My mother. Okay, good. Mucho, a veces nos emocionamos, ¿no? Y se nos sale por ahí mal el pronombre, pero hay que tener mucho cuidado con esto. Ok. So keep in mind that. Thank you, Arlette. Thank you guys for your answers. Let's move now to the next two questions we have. Ok, let's listen this time to Pedrito. Pedrito, can you help us reading these questions?
Good morning, teacher. Hello.
Hi, Pedrito. How are you?
Good, good. Do you buy things online? What do you buy?
Okay, exactly. Can you answer the questions, Pedrito, please?
Okay. Do you buy things online? Yes, although I am, what do you mean in English? Desconfianza, suspicious, desconfianza.
When you're suspicious, you are, suspicious sería como cuando estás, no estás tan seguro, estás sospechando de algo, ¿no? E inseguro sería insecure, or you can use, you don't trust, you no confía.
Oh, okay, okay. Entonces, yes, although I am insecure, what do you buy? A mountain backpack, maybe?
Okay, you bought a bike?
No, mountain backpack.
Ah, okay, a backpack.
Mochila de montaña.
Sí. Sorry, I heard a mountain bike. So yes, a mountain backpack.
Sorry, my pronunciation, teacher.
No, don't worry. It's because of the internet. Sometimes we don't listen clearly.
Okay, teacher.
Good, thank you. So Pedrito has bought a backpack. What about you, Milena? Have you ever bought something online?
No, teacher, never.
Never? Not even food?
No.
Okay. So what about you, Manu? Do you buy things online?
Yes.
What
yes, I do.
Buy?
I buy a computer.
Really?
Yeah.
Did it work?
Yes, too.
Good. So, what else have you bought, guys? Online. Let me see. Who hasn't talked yet? Kevin está muy calladito. Kevin, tell me, have you ever bought something online?
¿Cuál, Kevin, teacher?
Yepes o Piñeiras.
Both, los dos. Primero Piñeiras y luego Yepes.
Yeah.
¿Escucha, teacher?
Yes.
Okay. The question number four. Yes, I like buy the thing online. Because in the internet the different things, for example video games and computer and things technologies.
Hey.
Yes.
Good. So yes, you told me something very interesting. You now buy some computer games, right? When you have these machines like PlayStation and those things, you usually buy the new video games. They come through internet, right? Compramos por internet ahora los juegos. Good. Kevin Yepes, tell me.
Yes, teacher. If I usually buy things online, when I buy it is usually clothes.
Okay, clothes.
Yep.
Good. Thank you to my both Kevins. Thank you so much. So yes, now with this pandemic situation, we have to learn how to buy things online, right? And stores also have to learn how to sell things online. Sorry about the noise, guys. My cat just woke up crazy. She's playing all over the room. Okay, so there are a lot of things to buy online, but as Pedrito say, we need to be careful, right? Because we don't know if the people we're talking to are serious. Okay, so let's move, guys. As you can see here, you have an idea, a general idea of what are we going to talk about, right? ¿De qué iremos a hablar entonces hoy? ¿Tienen alguna idea de lo que vamos a hablar? Buying things, right? You're going to see some cases of buying things. Pay attention, guys, to the following picture and help me with the answer, okay? So here we have, look at this. Look at the picture and the words in the box below. What story do you think Mark is telling to Tom? What story do you think they are talking about? According to these words we have over here. ¿De qué creen ustedes que esté hablando estos dos señores aquí, Mark y Tom? De acuerdo con las palabras que tenemos ahí. What do you think? Narcy, can you help me with the answer? What story do you think they are talking to?
Oh, maybe party children.
Okay, maybe a party for the children could be. Thank you. Isamar, what do you think? What are these guys talking about?
I think very small.
Very small what? What do you think they are talking? ¿De qué estarán hablando? Aquí tenemos unas palabras que nos pueden dar una idea de lo que están hablando.
Sometimes it's very small.
Okay, they are talking about something that it's very small. Good. Thank you. Dianita Padilla, tell me, what do you think they are talking about? ¿De qué estarán hablando? Bien. Padilla, Padilla, wake up.
Yes, teacher. Job.
Okay, could be. They could be talking about job. You are going to watch a video, guys, to see what are they truly talking about, okay? So pay attention because you're going to see the video just now. Let me share the book with you so we can see the video, okay? Okay, let me share the sound of the computer so you can listen as well. But first, let me share with you the whole book. Okay, guys, pay attention and try to listen. Try to understand everything they are saying, okay? Pay attention and tell me, what are they talking about? ¿Sí? Me van a contar de qué están hablando estos dos señores. Can you see, guys, the book on the screen?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, let's begin then. Pay attention, everybody.
Hi, Mark.
Hi, Tom.
Hi, Paula.
Hi.
We're still meeting at 10, right?
Yes, we are. We're in meeting room 3, I think. See you in there.
Yep,
see you in a minute.
Coffee?
Yes, please.
So, did you have a good weekend?
It was good, thanks. But you won't believe what I did.
What?
Remember I told you my dad wanted a desk for his new office and I offered to help him find one online?
Oh yeah?
Well, I found one. It looked perfect. Exactly what I was looking for. It was a fantastic price too.
Sounds good.
Exactly. So I ordered it.
Great.
And it arrived on Saturday. But the funny thing is, it was really, really small.
How small?
It only came up to my knees.
Hey?
It turned out I'd ordered a desk for a child.
No way.
Mm-hmm. I forgot to check the measurements on the website.
Oh, so what did you do?
Okay, guys. So what were these guys talking about? What were they talking about, truly?
For the present. The present and maybe is very small. The parece que dijo como un escritorio que había pedido online.
Exactly, he asked a desk online. Okay, he asked a desk for who? Who was the desk for? Para quién era el escritorio?
Father.
Okay, yes, for Mark's dad, right? Era un escritorio para el papá de Mark, right? It was Mark's father's desk. Good. What happened with the desk? ¿Qué pasó con el escritorio?
It's a very small.
Exactly. It was very, very small. Why? Why was it small? ¿Por qué era?
Because he don't forget. Review the measurements to the desk in the online store.
Yes, he forgot to check the measurements. Good. Se olvidó de ver las escritorio, right? Y resultó que para quién era este escritorio pequeñito?
For a child.
Mm-hmm, exactly. It was for children, right? For a child. Era para niños el escritorio. That's why it was so cheap, right? Por eso también era tan económico. Good. So, as you can see, you had all the clues on the box. Sí, no teníamos todas las pistas en el cuadradito. Now, let's check, guys, these questions. You are going to tell me what was the mistake Mark did? ¿Cuál fue el error al comprar? Okay. Hey, help me. What was the mistake he made?
He forgot to revise the measurement of the desk.
Mm-hmm, exactly. So the mistake was that he didn't review or he didn't watch the measurements, right? Se olvidó de revisar las medidas en realidad del escritorio. So that was his mistake. Okay, guys. So here we're going to see some of the phrases they used when we were talking, then when they were talking, right? So help me, guys, matching the phrases with the answers. Here we have, you won't believe what I did. What do you think it's the answer? ¿Cómo respondieron a esta primera frase? No vas a ¿qué hice?
Letter B.
What?
What?
Mm-hmm. Letter B, right? What? No me vas a creer lo que hice el fin de semana. La otra persona les va a decir, ¿qué? ¿Qué hiciste? ¿No es cierto? What? Number two. It was a fantastic prize too.
Sounds good.
Okay, letter C. Sounds good. Good. Okay, let me write it over here. Sounds good. Perfect. So, estaba en un precio buenísimo, ¿no es cierto? Tenía un precio fantástico. Suena bien. Okay, sounds good. Number three. So, I order it.
Great.
Great.
Great. Mm-hmm. Entonces, la compré, ¿no es cierto? Si tenía un buen precio, la compré. Genial. Great. Number four, it turned out I'd order a desk for a child.
No way.
No way, right? What do you think it's the meaning of this phrase? No way.
No hay manera.
Si lo traducimos literalmente, sí, sería como no hay manera, ¿no? Pero no hay camino. Pero en este contexto, esta es una frase idiomática. Mucho cuidado con las frases idiomáticas porque esas, si las traducimos literalmente, no van a tener sentido. Y en este caso, el no way es cuando ustedes están respondiendo a algo un poco sorprendente, ¿no? Aquí les dice, it turned out I ordered a desk for a child. Resultó que compré el escritorio para un niño. No way. Es como que no te puedo creer, ¿no? Más o menos sería así. No te creo, no te puedo creer. Something like that, like a way of showing surprise could be. Sí, es una manera también como de responder de forma sorprendida a algo que nos está contando alguien, okay? So no way would be a new phrase in this case. Tell me, guys, which of these four phrases we have over here do you think are going to help us to respond something in a positive way? ¿Con cuál de estas frases estaríamos respondiendo de forma positiva?
Sounds good.
Great. Sounds good.
Exactly, perfect. So letter A and letter C. Sounds good and great. In which of these phrases you show surprise?
No way.
No way, exactly. No way.
Maybe. What?
What?
Exactly. The last one would be what? Asking for more information. When you ask for more information. Cuando quieren saber qué pasó, ¿no? Queremos saber más información de lo sucedido. So,
teacher, we can use what happened?
Yes. Yes, yes. When you want to know more information, you can say what happened, tell me more. También podría ser una opción. So let me write it. So let me write, we had the option what, right? We have the option of what happened that you said. Happened. We have tell me more. This could be some of the phrases we can use when we want to know more information, okay? Cuando queremos saber más información o queremos que nos cuenten más del chisme, ¿no? El chisme completo. What happened? Tell me more. Dime más, cuéntame más, ¿no? Tell me more. Good. So, let's see what we have here. Underline two other ways to show surprise in the exchange below. Which other phrases do you think we can use to show surprise in this short conversation? ¿Y qué otras frases también nos permiten como sorprendernos cuando nos cuentan algo, ¿sí? En esta conversación pequeñita que tenemos aquí. Let me ask some of your classmates to help me reading. Sí, voy a pedir a dos de ustedes que me ayuden leyendo esta pequeña conversación. Alexandra Simbaña me va a ayudar leyendo las de la letra A. Letter A. Okay. So Alexandra me va a ayudar leyendo estas en azul. Y letter B, la letra B, me va a ayudar leyendo, please, this time, Dieguito Castillo. You're going to help me reading letter B, okay?
Okay. Evita's about my sister's birthday present. She loves running. So I got head a sports watch.
Wow, that's a coincidence. I ordered one for myself yesterday.
Really? What make did you get?
Mm-hmm, exactly. Thank you, guys. So now, can you help me? Which other phrases can we use to show surprise? ¿Qué otras frases nos podemos sorprender entonces?
Wow.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Well, that's a coincidence.
Really?
Okay, really? Exactly. These two phrases can help us show in surprise, right? When somebody else is telling you a very surprising story, you can say, wow, or wow, no? It's going to depend on how fantastic it's the story you're listening to. Sometimes you can also use this word really. Really, it's going to have different meanings and you're going to know the exact meaning with the pronunciation of the other person, the intonation, you know? For example, you can say, really? Like asking a question could be like something surprising, ¿sí? Really nos puede servir para expresar mucho, ¿no? Con el really ustedes podrían estar como sorprendiéndose, entre comillas, por algo que ustedes no creen que pasó de una forma un poco sarcástica, ¿sí? O podrían sorprenderse en verdad, pero todo va a depender del tono con el que ocupen el really. ¿Sí? Este really tiene ese significado en español equivalente a un en serio, ¿sí? Estaríamos preguntando, ¿en serio? So, for example, In this case, we have, whoa, that's a coincidence, right? I offered one for myself yesterday. Really? Sí, ayer es una coincidencia. Ayer compré un reloj también para mí, ¿no es cierto? ¿En serio? Estamos preguntando, ¿en serio? Wow, ¿no? It's like something very surprising. So don't forget about these two phrases too. Si no nos olvidemos de estas otras dos frases también. Now, guys, we're going to complete these short beginnings with something that it's true for you. Sí, me van a ayudar a completar estas frases con hechos que son reales para ustedes. Sí, for example, something you like or you don't like. Let's see, Majito, what do you like? Tell us, share with us this information. Majito, cuéntanos, ¿qué te gusta? Maybe something you like to do, you like to eat, I don't know.
Hello, teacher. I like strawberry.
Good. You like strawberries. That's thick.
I don't like quinoa soup.
You don't like
quinoa soup.
Oh, you like quinoa soup. My husband doesn't like either, so I know how you feel. Yes, 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 I know. Thank you. Let's see number two. Last week I, vamos a ver, ¿qué hicieron la semana pasada? Let's see, what did you do? Genesis, tell me, last week I...
Teacher, repeat, please.
Can you complete this sentence? ¿Me vas a ayudar a completar esta oración con algo que tú hiciste? Last week I...
Okay. The trip to Tulcan City, or my visit my family.
Okay, thank you, Genesis. So last week Genesis traveled to Tulcan. Great, great, sounds good. Let's see number three. Can you help me with completing number three? I really want to. What do you really want to do, Victor? I really want to.
I really want to visit my parents.
Okay, where do they live?
I live in Tabacundo.
Oh, good, good. Thank you. That sounds good. So you really want to visit your parents. Thank you, Victor. What about you? What do you really want, Steffi?
Good morning, teacher.
Good morning.
Travel all over the Ecuador.
Wow, that's fantastic. Yes. So Steffi wants to travel around Ecuador. That sounds amazing. Good. Let's see the last one. What do you really want? What do you really want? Let me see. Dieguito, what do you really want?
I really want to play soccer.
Okay. So Dieguito really wants to play soccer. Okay, good. So let's see the last one. Vamos a la última. I haven't been to. ¿Dónde no han estado? ¿En qué lugar no han estado ustedes, chicos? Tell me this time, David. David Venegas, I haven't been to.
Okay, teacher. I have not been to Guayaquil.
Okay, wow. You haven't been to Guayaquil. You really need to go and visit Guayaquil, especially in holidays, in Christmas holidays. It's very nice. So let's see, where haven't you been? Luisito, I haven't been to.
I haven't been to many places, but for example, in the cart.
Okay. You haven't been in Carchi? I couldn't listen to you clearly.
Yes, in Carchi.
Okay, wow. That's interesting. So I didn't know you didn't, or you haven't been there. Somebody else is missing over here and hasn't talked. So can you help me with the answer of the last question? I just saw you. Panchito, Francisco, can you help me with the last one?
Yes, teacher.
I haven't been to.
I haven't been to the Oriente.
Wow. No way.
No.
Look, you can answer to these questions with phrases like that. Thank you, Panchito. So you haven't been to the Amazonic region of our country. Okay, good. It's good to know. I'm always glad to listen to you guys. Sí, siempre es bueno escucharles y ver cómo están ustedes participando. It doesn't matter if we make mistakes because we can improve them. Si no importa si nos equivocamos porque podemos ir mejorando. Good, guys. So keep in mind these phrases because you're going to need them afterwards. Sí, vamos a utilizar estas frases despuesito. Okay. So pay attention to the next thing. Here we have some other phrases we can use when we react to what people say. The phrases we saw are not the only ones. Y las frases que escuchamos o que vimos no son las únicas que podemos ocupar. Here are some phrases we can use in specific situations. For example, we were talking about something interesting, right? Cuando alguien les cuenta una historia, un chisme o lo que sea, pero está interesante la cosa, ustedes pueden utilizar el really, ¿no es cierto? Really, ¿en serio? ¿No? There are some other phrases as the ones that we have over here on the left side that can help us also to react to different situations. ¿Sí? Estas frases, en cambio, que tenemos en la parte izquierda, las vamos a ocupar para algunas otras situaciones. Ya vamos a ver cuáles situaciones, ¿ok? Can you help me reading the phrases, please, Nico? Help me reading the phrases. Wake up, Nicolás.
Yeah, okay, teacher. The first is, oh no, I don't believe it. You're kidding. What's a pity. Never mind. How fantastic. What a great idea. That's a great news.
Mm-hmm, exactly. Thank you. So these phrases we can use to react to what people say, but we're going to see in which specific situations we can use them. Sí, vamos a ver en qué situaciones específicas podemos ocupar estas frases. La primera que teníamos era really para algo interesante, ¿no? When we listen to something interesting, we can say really. Okay, let's move to the next. Vamos a la siguiente. Ya vimos la primera y aquí tenemos el really. Here we have what you say when you hear good news. Lo que nosotros podemos contestar cuando nos están contando buenas noticias. Okay, let's see. What can we say? Let me see. Mm-hmm. ¿Quién me va a ayudar leyendo? Alexandra, help me reading, please. This time, what you say when you listen to good news?
Okay. What you say when you hear good news? How fantastic. That's great news. What a great idea.
Exactly. So we have three phrases. How fantastic. That's great news. Or what a great idea. What else do you say when you listen to some good news? ¿Qué más ustedes dicen cuando les dan una buena noticia? For example, if I told you, si les digo, you don't have the midterm exam tomorrow.
¿Qué va a ser? Oh, good.
¿Qué para ustedes?
Oh, no.
Para Dianita, oh no. Para los otros, good. So yes, you can use any good or any positive adjective. Sí, podemos ocupar cualquier adjetivo que tenga una connotación positiva, ¿no es cierto? You can also say, what else you can say? Les estoy dando la ayudadita.
Great.
Great.
Excellent. Great. What else can you say? Cuando quieren decir genial.
Awesome.
Awesome. Good. Great. Awesome. Fantastic. Excellent. Perfect.
Sounds good.
Sounds good. Mm-hmm. Muy bien, aquí entraría ese sounds good. Oops. Aquí tenemos algunas frases que podemos ocupar, ¿no es cierto? Cuando hablamos de buenas noticias. So, keep in mind that. What happened on the other hand when you were listening to some bad news? ¿Qué dicen ustedes cuando escuchan malas noticias? Si les digo, listen everybody, we need to change the exam. So you're going to have the exam today. Si les digo que cambiamos el examen para hoy, ¿qué dirían ustedes?
Oh no.
Oh no.
That's great.
Oh no.
It's terrible.
It's terrible. Good.
Really?
Okay, you could also use really, en serio, pero ese sí sería un en serio malo, ¿no? Really? Okay. We have this one also. Oops. Can you remember? Synonym of terrible. Hay un sinónimo para terrible. That's
awful.
Awful.
Awful. Good. Mm-hmm. Uy, eso está muy malo, ¿no es cierto? That's awful. Good.
So, poor me.
Poor me. Good. Poor me. ¿No es cierto? Pobre de mí. Ya valí en inglés. Me toman hoy el examen. Good. So here we have different phrases we can use when we listen to bad news, right? What a pity. That's terrible. That's awful. Never mind. Poor me. No, este never mind sería como... No importa, ¿no? Como ya nada, ¿no? Never mind. So, good guys, you helped me with a lot of extra options of phrases we can say when we listen to good or bad news. Now, we're going to see which phrases can we use. Vamos a ver ahora otras frases. But when we listen to something surprising, ¿sí? Cuando nos cuentan algo sorprendente. Here we have two phrases. We have I don't believe it. ¿Sí? No lo puedo creer. Y tenemos you're kidding. ¿Sí? Generalmente este you're kidding va acompañado por el right. You're kidding, right? Estás bromeando, ¿verdad? Sí, a eso se refiere este you're kidding. Estás bromeando. There's another phrase we can use also. That would be kind of a synonym of you're kidding. That is pull my leg. Y este don't pull my leg means no me tomes del pelo, no estés jugando conmigo, no bromees con eso. Don't pull my leg. Okay. Y en cambio el you're kidding tendríamos para cuando ustedes les dicen algo asombroso, sorprendente y ustedes dicen es broma, ¿verdad? You're kidding, right? So keep in mind these phrases, guys, to show surprise. Por ahí apunten estas frasecitas que podemos ocupar para demostrar un poco de sorpresa, ¿no? Hey, let's move to the next, guys. Let me just move. Here you're going to see some of the phrases we just saw. They are ordered over here. Sí, aquí ya tenemos ordenadas las frases. What we can say in these different situations. And we have some situations. So you're going to tell me how would you react if you listen to this news. ¿Sí? ¿Cómo reaccionarían ustedes ante estas noticias? Pay attention, guys. The first one we have is Kate's going traveling for a year. ¿Sí? Kate se va a viajar todo un año, ¿no? How would you answer? ¿Cómo contestaríamos ante esta noticia? Here we have, what a great idea, right? What a great idea would be like the first. What about number two? I've left my wallet at home again. ¿Cómo responderían ustedes si salen a cenar con sus amigos o con alguien y les dicen, I've left my wallet at home again? Me olvidé la billetera en la casa. How would you answer? How fantastic?
I don't believe it.
I don't believe it. You're kidding. Okay, could be. I don't believe it. No lo puedo creer, ¿no es cierto? Or you can say, si la persona que se olvidó la billetera era la que iba a pagar, ¿qué le van a decir?
You're kidding, really?
Really?
You're kidding, right? ¿No es cierto? Really? Estás bromeando, ¿no es cierto? ¿Y ahora qué hacemos? Go and wash the dishes. Okay, good. Think about the following situation. You didn't get the job you were looking for.
What a pity.
What a pity, exactly. Qué pena, ¿no es cierto? No encontraste el trabajo que estabas buscando. What a pity. What about the next? We're getting married. How would you answer?
Oh, no.
Okay, oh, no.
That's a great news.
Would be, that's great news. Mm-hmm. It can also be how fantastic, but it's going to depend on the situation and on the people who are getting married, right? Va a depender mucho de las personas que se estén casando. Si saben que es un completo error que se casen, you're going to say, as Pedrito told us, oh no, right? Pero si son personas que no creo que tengan problema casándose, you can say, That's great news, right? Let's see what happened with the situation number five. David or Dave's got a new car. He has got a new car.
Really?
Really? Exactly. Really? En serio? Really good. Let's see the last one. I've lost my phone.
Oh no.
Oh no, exactly. This is definitely going to be a bad news answer, right? Oh no. So, yes. Thank you guys. So here we have some ideas, some phrases we can use when we are reacting to what people say. So keep in mind these phrases because you're going to need them later. Let me see, we have the next video. So let me move to the presentation and you can do this activity as well. You're going to see a picture, guys. Pay attention to the picture and tell me. Okay, let me share with you the presentation again. There you go. Can you see the presentation, guys?
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Help me answering this question. What do you think Mark did when he discovered his mistake? ¿Qué creen que hizo Mark cuando se dio cuenta de su error? What do you think he did?
He returned this desk.
Okay, could be. He returned the desk. That's an option. What do you think he did, Kevin Piñeros?
For example, in the Amazon, bueno, no sé cómo sería devolver el producto.
Okay, you can return the product. Let me write it below. What other option you have? ¿Qué otra opción hay cuando uno no está como contento con lo que compró?
They maybe change the product picture.
Okay. You could also change the product. Good.
Give a complaint to the offers online.
Good. You can complain. Mm-hmm. Podemos quejarnos, ¿no es cierto? Sobre el producto. What if you don't want to return the product, you don't want to change the product, but you want to have your money back. How do you say that? ¿Cómo dirían ustedes cuando quieren que les devuelvan el dinero? What's the meaning? Oh, how do you
say that?
Exactly. You want a refund. Good. ¿No es cierto? Quieren un reembolso de su dinero. Quieren que les devuelvan el dinero porque no era tal vez lo que acordaron, ¿no es cierto? So, here we have some options you can do when you have made a mistake buying something online, right? Algunas de las cosas que podríamos hacer para en algo solucionar el problema, ¿no? De comprar algo en línea. Return the product, devolver el producto, cambiar el producto, change the product, complain, make a complaint, ¿sí? Quejarnos, o pedir un reembolso, ¿no? Ask for a refund. So here we have some of the options. Good. We're going to see what did he do. Vamos a ver qué fue lo que hizo Mark. And you're going to help me listening very, very carefully because you're going to help me with the following answers, guys. Here we have five statements. 5 sentences. You are going to see if they are true or false according to the video, okay? Vamos a ver si son verdaderas o falsas dependiendo del video. So before we watch the video, we're going to read the sentences so we have an idea of what do we have to pay attention to. ¿Sí? Antes de empezar con el video, vamos a leer cuáles son las frases que vamos a estar pendientes, ¿sí?, en el video para poder responder. So, can you help me reading the first one, please? Help me reading, Pedrito.
The company Mark bought the desk from Didn't Other Around.
Mm-hmm. The company Mark bought the desk from Didn't Offer a Refund. Sí, la compañía donde él compró el escritorio no le ofreció un reembolso. Let's see number two. Can you help me reading, please, Oscar?
Yes, yes, teacher.
Help me reading number two. Joelito, ayúdame leyendo nomás.
Yes, teacher, one moment, please. Okay. Looking on a free client website for a new desk was Rachel's idea.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Oscar. Let's move to number three. Evelyn, can you help me reading?
Recycling is where people can give away unwanted things.
Okay, recycling is a place where people can give away unwanted things. Good, let's see number four. Help me reading this time, please, Manu.
Tom already know about the website.
Mm-hmm. Tom already knew about this website, Freecycling. Él ya conocía de este lugar, ¿no? De esta página web. And the last one, Alan, help me reading number five.
Mark is waiting for the desk to be delivered.
Mm-hmm. Mark is waiting for the desk to be delivered. Mark está esperando a que le entreguen, ¿no? A que le despachen el escritorio. Let's see if these statements are true or false. Vamos a ver si son verdaderos o falsos. Pay attention to the video, guys, so you can tell me the answers. Vamos a ver cuáles son las respuestas de esta segunda parte del video. So, let me share with you the book. Tell me, guys, can you see the book?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, let's begin then.
So what did you do?
Well, I phoned the company to explain, and luckily they agreed to give me a refund.
Really? That was very good of them.
Yeah, it was. But anyway, I still had to find a desk. I was looking everywhere, but I couldn't find anything. In the end, Rachel suggested I try one of those free cycling websites.
Free cycling? What's that?
It's where people get rid of stuff they don't want anymore. I'd never heard of it either, but there are a couple of websites for this area. I found the perfect desk straight away, and the best thing is, it's free.
It's free?
Yeah. I think the owner doesn't have enough space for it, so he's just giving it away. So all I have to do is go and pick it up.
Wow. That's good. Are you sure it's the right size this time?
Yeah, I'll double check the measurements this time.
Guys!
Oh, sorry, Paula. It's my fault. I was just explaining to Tom about my desk mix-up.
Okay, guys, we're going to re-watch it just one last time so you can give me all the answers, okay? So this time we're going to check some phrases we can use when we want to tell a story, when we want to start the story, when we are telling the story, and when we want to finish that story. But before that, we're going to listen to these phrases so you can help me completing the blank spaces, okay? Vamos a escuchar estas seis oraciones y ustedes me van a escuchar, me van a ayudar completando los espacios en blanco, okay? So pay attention, guys, and listen to the record so you can help me with the answers, okay? I will be making some pauses after each phrase. Sí, voy a ir pausando después de cada frase para que ustedes me puedan ayudar con cada una de ellas. Let's begin then.
Track 1.51. 1.
You won't believe what I did.
2.
The funny thing is, it was really, really small.
So, what's the answer of number 2?
Is it funny?
Funny.
Uh-huh, exactly, the funny thing. No, y lo divertido o lo chistoso de todo esto es que era muy, muy pequeño, ¿no? The funny thing is, it was really, really small. Let's move to the next one. Vamos a ver la número 3.
3.
It turned out I'd ordered a desk for a child.
What would it be?
Turned out.
Exactly. It turned out. Resultó ser, ¿no es cierto? Y resultó ser que ordené un escritorio para niños. It turned out. I'd order a desk for a child. Y resultó que ordené un escritorio para niños. Let's see the next one, guys.
4.
But anyway, I still had to find a desk.
But?
Anyway.
Good, anyway. Pero de todas formas, de todas maneras, tengo que seguir buscando un escritorio, ¿no? But anyway, I still had to find a desk. Good, let's see or let's listen to number 5.
5.
In the end, Rachel suggested I try one of those free cycling websites.
Okay, so in the
end. In the end.
Exactly, in the end. So in the end, Rachel suggested I try one of those free cycling websites. Excellent. And let's listen to the last phrase over here. Vamos a la última frase.
6.
I found the perfect desk straight away. And the best thing is, it's free.
Oh, the last one. I found the perfect desk straight away. And?
Best.
Good. And the best thing is that it's free, right? Y lo mejor o la mejor parte de toda la historia es que es gratis, ¿no? It's free. Good. So keep in mind these phrases. Here are some phrases we can use when we want to tell a story. Sí, aquí tenemos algunas frases que podemos ocupar para contar una historia. For example, from the phrases we have from 1 to 6, ¿sí? De las frases que acabamos de completar, de la 1 a la 6. Tell me, which phrase would you use to start a story? ¿Sí? ¿Qué frase ocuparían ustedes para empezar una historia?
You won't believe it what I did.
Exactly. You won't believe what I did, right? No me vas a creer lo que me pasó. You won't believe what I did. Good. No me vas a creer lo que hice. What about adding information? Cuando ustedes quieren información a su historia.
The funny thing is, the
best.
Okay, we can use phrase number two. We can use the best thing is, could be. What would you use?
The best thing is.
What else can you say when you want to?
But anyway.
Good, but anyway. And what else?
Teacher, maybe the traduction, y lo peor de todo, and the worst of all, se estaría bien utilizarle la...
Podríamos utilizar, and the worst thing is, y lo peor de todo fue, no necesitamos poner and the worst of all, sí, lo peor de todo. Ya con decir the worst thing is, sí, lo peor que pasó fue, the worst thing, si quieres hablar ya de lo peor, podría ser the worst. Pero si es algo bueno, una noticia buena, podrías decir the best. Uh-huh. Pero sí se puede sustituir con the worst.
Ok, thank you.
Mm-hmm. The last one we have, it turned out. Sí, y resultó ser que, ¿no es cierto? Cuando están ustedes contando el chisme y por ahí, algo inesperado pasa, ¿no? It turned out. Ta, 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 ta. What do you use to end the story? ¿Qué frase ocuparíamos para ya terminarla?
In the end.
The end, exactly. In the end. Sí, al final pasó tal cosa, right? Good, guys. Here we have on the right side, you have some extra phrases you can use. Sí, aquí tenemos algunas frases extra que podríamos ocupar. Sí, to start the story, we can use phrases like this one. Cuando ustedes están empezando una historia, podríamos ocupar, you won't believe what I did, ¿no es cierto? La que acabamos de ver, no me vas a creer lo que hice. Guess what? ¿Sí? Por ahí ustedes llegan a la universidad y le dicen a su mejor amigo o amiga, guess what? ¿Sí? Adivina qué. Right? Is a way to start a story. Es una forma ya de empezar una historia. Guess what? Adivina qué. You will love this. ¿Sí? Te va a encantar lo que te voy a contar, ¿no? You will love this. Or maybe you can use, did you hear about, ¿no? ¿Escuchaste sobre? Y ahí empiezan a empezar su historia, ¿no? Did you hear about coming back to face-to-face classes? Por ejemplo, ¿escuchaste sobre lo de regresar a clases presenciales? Y ahí empieza el chisme, ¿no? Ahí empieza la historia. So keep in mind those phrases we can use to start a story. Acuérdense de estas frases que tenemos para empezar una historia. Mucho ojo. Guess what, ¿sí? El guess what nos sirve para decir adivina qué, ¿sí? Pero si alguien, o sea, la otra persona con la que ustedes están conversando les dice, déjame adivinar, ¿sí? Es porque esa persona quiere tratar de ver si es que está en lo correcto, ¿no? Es decir, que podría decir, let me guess, déjame adivinar. You're going back to classes next week, for example. Déjame adivinar, regresas a clases la siguiente semana. ¿Sí? So, we can keep on playing with this verb guess. Este verbo guess es una de las palabras más utilizadas cuando hablan en inglés, ¿no? Que quiere o significa adivinar en este caso. Look at this. Continuing with this verb, ¿sí? Continuando con este verb. Verbo, cuando ustedes quieren como que la conversación se alargue un poquito y hacer más interesante su historia, podrían ocupar frases como estas, ¿no? Guess what happened next. Adivina qué pasó después, ¿no? Guess what happened next. The funny part was. ¿Sí? Lo más chistoso fue que. The funniest part was. Y ahí cuentan, ¿no? ¿Qué fue lo más chistoso? ¿Qué fue lo más triste? ¿Qué fue lo más...? Ahí ya dependería de ustedes. Podrían cambiar el adjetivo, ¿no? Aquí tenemos un superlativo. The craziest part was. Sí, lo más loco fue que. ¿Ok? Remember, guys, that when you are telling a story, acuérdense que cuando están contando una historia, a veces se nos va de las manos, ¿no? Y empezamos a divagar. Y salimos por la tangente. When you want to go back to your story, ¿sí? Cuando quieren regresar a la historia principal, you can use anyway or back to my story. ¿Sí? Cualquiera de estas dos frases nos serían muy útiles. Anyway or back to my story. De todas formas, regresando a mi historia, ¿no es cierto? Back to my story. Y otra forma de terminar una historia que no sea al final, ¿no es cierto? In the end, podríamos ocupar I couldn't believe it. It was so embarrassed. ¿Sí? I was so embarrassed. Estaba tan apenado, tan avergonzado, ¿no es cierto? Puede ser una forma de terminar, ¿no es cierto? Están ustedes contando y dicen I was so embarrassed. Sí, estaba tan, tan avergonzado. Or it was awesome, right? Fue fantástico. Fue increíble. It was awesome. So, keep in mind, guys, these phrases, because you're going to need them after the break. Sí, vamos a ocupar estas frases justo después del break. Okay? So, let's see if you, before we move to the speaking section, let me share with you a link of some, of a short exercise we're gonna make, okay? About these phrases. So, let me send you the link on the chat so everybody can have it. And you can open it without any problem. So, oops, no, that's not the code. No es ese el código, chicos, no abran, es el último. Can you see the last code on the chat?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, guys. So what are we going to do? You're going to open the link and you're going to complete the exercise. We're just matching some of the phrases with the corresponding category, okay? So let me show you. This is what you're going to do. Sí, aquí tenemos lo que vamos a hacer. You're going to play this short game. Y van a jugar este pequeño juego donde van a ir uniendo, ¿no? Las opciones que tienen en la izquierda con cada una de las categorías. What do you say when something is surprising, something is interesting, something is good news or bad news, okay? Once you end, una vez que terminen, me van a enviar la captura con su score, con el puntaje que obtuvieron, ¿sí? Al grupo de WhatsApp. Okay, let's begin, guys. 5 minutes to do it. Vamos a ver entonces cómo nos...
¿Le enviamos la captura, teacher?
Ajá. Yes, yes. Tell me, guys, what did you put in something surprising?
You're kidding.
You're kidding, okay. What else?
I don't believe.
I don't believe it. Good. What about something interesting?
Really?
Really? What else? What did you use with some good news?
Oh, fantastic.
Okay, how fantastic.
That's great news.
That's great news. What else did you use?
What a good idea.
What a good idea. Excellent. And the last three we have are definitely for bad news, right? What a pity, never mind, and oh no. So these are going to be for bad news. Good. Thank you, guys. Yes. There were no, there wasn't any score. Si no tuvimos puntaje final. Anyway, it doesn't matter, guys. No importa. Thank you so much. It's just for you to keep in mind how do you use these phrases. Sí, únicamente es para recordar cómo ocupar estas frases. Okay? Good. Hi, Diego. Hi, Luis.
Teacher, no le prendo la cámara porque el internet se me va medio. No, no se escucha bien.
Don't worry, Luis. Go ahead.
Y entonces, good morning, teacher. Let's start with the practice, speaking practice.
What's up, Luis?
Hi, Diego. You won't believe what happened to me. Ten days ago, I had to travel to the province of Chimborazo with my basketball team for a championship.
How fantastic, bro.
We had to travel 8 hours on public transport. It was a very tiring trip.
Oh no, it's terrible.
The funny thing is that when we go to the place, it was raining very hard and it was very cold. But anyway, we won first place in the championship.
That's a great news. Luis, you will love this. A story about a trip I had.
What?
Last year, I have been in San Andres, some beautiful beaches in Colombia. I traveled with my girlfriend. These beaches have beautiful water as you can see in the photo.
It's a great.
On that beach, you can have many experiences. For example, being with fish, walking, romantic diners, etc.
You really want to go?
Well, tell you later, bro.
Okay, bye.
Good, guys. Thank you. I like that you use some phrases that are sound more natural when you're talking. They are muy bien las frases, al menos para iniciar. No están como, hello, my friends, you know, what's up, bro, how you doing? And this sounds more natural, you know. Just pay attention in the pronunciation of some words such as dinner. Si no se olviden de la pronunciación de cena. En este caso sería dinner, ¿sí? And I think that you were saying something about the water, maybe, Diego? Decías
algo,
el agua, ¿no? Que es como, como en las fotos. Okay, good. So keep in mind also the
presence. Me trabé.
Water, sí, te trabaste y ahí me perdí un poco. Okay, but nothing else. The rest was very good, very clear. Thank you so much, guys. No se olviden de subir la evidencia a la evidencia, a la evidencia, a la, a la.
Estoy despeinado, bro.
Don't worry.
En pijama, sí.
En pijama, sí. No, está frío. Las mañanas están frías, profe. Están frías.
Yes, I know. It's very...
The morning is cool. No, it's freezing.
It's freezing. Good.
It's freezing.
It's freezing.
Ya. Entonces... bueno, hello everyone, my name is Brian Rosero and my partner is Nicolas Gordillo, and today I'm going to talk about an accident
that I have.
Okay.
Yes. Accident.
let's start. Hi Brian, you won't believe what happened.
Hi Nico, tell me, was it bad, funny, interesting?
It was bad because I had an accident.
You're kidding. Tell me what happened.
Yesterday in the mechanic of the municipality, I was working in a car. I was tightening a screw with a pipe. Suddenly my partner dropped a tool and hit my knee. And now I can't walk correctly.
It's awful. Are you okay?
Not quite right, because I have to move slowly.
Should you go to the doctor for an X-ray, or have you already taken something for the pain?
That's a great idea. I need to take a pill. The worst thing of all is the pain doesn't go away.
What a pity. I really must go, but I'm going to visit you tonight and bring you something for the pain. Take care, Nico.
Sure, I'll speak to you tonight. You too, bye.
Awesome, guys. Awesome. I don't have anything to say. You sound natural, you keep the conversation fluent, so I can understand everything you say. Even you won't share the screen with me, I could understand everything you said. So working with you is awesome as always. And don't forget, guys, I told you to upload the evidence on speaking practice number 4, but I was wrong. It was on speaking practice number 5. So that's the task that it will be available for you.
Hi, Diani. How are you? Diani?
Hi, fine. And you?
And you can't believe this. In the last months, I bought a new car in Quito.
Oh, that sounds good.
Yeah, I'm in a good place. In the same day, I went to the Chachimbiro and the car is broken.
You're kidding, but the car was new.
Yes, the car was new. I called the seller to complain.
What a pity. And what happened?
He gave me my money back and I bought a better car.
That's great news. So you can visit more places.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, see you later. Bye.
Okay, bye.
Okay, guys. Oh my God. This is something incredible that the seller gave you a full refund of your...
it's about the story.
Yes, no, don't worry. The thing is that you kept the story going, and this is how it works. When you are in a speaking test, it doesn't matter what you're saying, if it's true or false, but the thing is that we want to listen to you and keep on talking. Just one thing, guys. Manu, when you were saying, you can't believe this, you won't believe this. No me vas a creer esto. ¿Sí? You won't believe. O en ese caso, si quieres utilizar el verbo poder, podría ser, can you believe this? ¿Sí? Primero el verbo modal, can, y luego el sujeto con pregunta. Cambia de lugar cuando preguntamos. ¿Sí? Can you believe this? ¿Me puedes creer esto? Si quieres decir, me puedes, ¿no? Pero la frase correcta sería you won't believe this. No me vas a creer esto, ¿no? Como en futuro.
Yeah, teacher.
O nunca me creerías esto. You will never believe this.
You will never believe this. Mm-hmm. Yeah, teacher.
Keep in mind that, guys. Nothing more to say, but that you use the phrases I asked for and that it was an incredible story. So thank you so much, guys.
Hello, teacher. Yeah, hello, Kevin.
Hello, Majo.
I tell you that this weekend I went to the beach.
Really? And how was it?
It did not go well for me.
Oh no.
You can we imagine what happened to me.
What happened?
I tell you that I reserved a room in the hotel and it was in bad condition and they didn't not want to return the money.
Oh, it's terrible. What did you do?
I looked for a hotel at the time and from there everything went very well.
Oh, fantastic. I'm glad for you.
See you later, Kevin.
See you. Bye-bye.
Thank you, teacher.
Thank you.
Hey, guys. Okay, let me just check my notes. Majo, we need to improve the fluency. Sí, nos toca todavía pulir la fluidez. Hay que repasar y repasar y repasar, sobre todo porque su suficiencia está a la vuelta de la esquina. ¿Sí? Y tal vez yo les tengo un poco de paciencia, pero si les toca con un profesor que les intimide ya en face to face exam, se van a poner nerviosos y se van a bloquear. ¿Sí?
Teacher, una pregunta.
Hay que trabajar. Dime, Kevin.
Bueno, me dijeron que al acabar esto de los cursos, ¿es obligatorio de una ir a rendir la suficiencia?
La mayor parte de los casos, sí, porque la mayoría de los que siguieron este curso son estudiantes que están ya en egresados, por egresar, y algunos estudiantes, no sé si es que les van a pedir ya la suficiencia para matricularse al siguiente nivel, los que van a...
Sí,
entonces, sí, en su caso me parece, no sé si es que la siguiente fecha ustedes alcancen para diciembre, que creo que no, porque salimos del 20 con ustedes y 20 se cierra inglés, más bien ustedes entrarían a la primera suficiencia del siguiente año, que es en enero.
Okay, teacher.
Good morning, teachers. In this moment, my classmate Arlette and I, Diana, we are going to have a conversation. Hi, Arlette. How are you?
Hi, Diana. Fine, thank you. How did on the trip?
You won't believe what I did.
What?
I was delighted on the fly.
I don't believe it.
Yes, I was traveling with my boyfriend and he was upset because I was late.
Where did you go?
Our trip was to Galapagos.
Oh, fantastic. How many days did you stay there?
We stayed for a week, but the funny thing is that I forget my camera and we only take photos with my cell phone.
What a pity.
Yes, poor me. Anyway, we are in love with this place.
You took pictures with the turtles?
No, because we didn't have time.
You're kidding, right?
Yes, obvious that I take a lot of pictures with all the animals.
I would have liked to go too.
What a great idea, Arlette. We can go next year.
Yes, friend, please. See you, then I have class.
See you soon, Arlette. Take care, bye.
Bye, Dianita.
Excellent, ladies. I like that you try to keep the conversation fluent. That's good. Just a few things, Arlette. When you were asking the first question, how did you do on the trip? How did you do on the trip? A veces tienen escrito y se olvidan de pronunciar todo. ¿Sí? How did you do on the trip? Nos faltó el you do. Sí, porque ahí estaba como incompleto lo que te escuché, pero te entendí lo que querías decir. How did you do on the trip? Y al final tenías la frase, I would like to go too, ¿no? Me gustaría ir también. Para reafirmar, acuérdense que el inglés es muy reiterativo, ¿no? Necesitamos repetir quién hace la acción o en dónde se hace la acción. En este caso, I would like to go there too. Sí, me gustaría también ir allá. So, I would like to go there too. También me gustaría ir allá. Okay. And, Dianita, there was just one phrase I missed. Sí, se me fue una frase por ahí que no sé si la escuché bien. We are in love with this place. ¿Era la frase? No, algo como que nos
encanta. Yes, we are in love with this place. Estamos enamorados.
Sí, sí, sí. Very good. Yes, we are in love with this place. Good. No, está muy bien la frase. Solo quería cerciorarme porque a veces con el internet no les escucho muy bien. Okay, ladies, very good. Excellent work. Congratulations. You're going to have some rest because we're moving to the rest of the groups. Sí, nos vamos nosotros a los siguientes grupos, pero ustedes descansan un ratito.
Thank you, teacher.
Okay.
You can start.
Hi, teacher. Hi, teacher Patty. I'm going to talk about the conversation with my friend Alan. Hello, Alan.
Hey, bro. What's up?
I'm good. And you?
Somewhat tired and just got off a work.
Oh, dear. Poor you.
Really? You feel sorry for me?
No, man. But I am happy.
Good. And why are you happy?
Because last week I found a new job.
Oh, fantastic. That's good news.
Yeah, I could believe it.
And what are you going to do in the new job?
I am the new security guard.
Really? You quit your old job to become a guard?
No, man, I am manager, the business manager.
Oh, fantastic. Good for you.
And the best part is if I need a guard, I will can you.
Oh, no, poor me.
I'm kidding. You will love this. If I need a collage, I will can you.
Okay, in the end, good luck in your new job.
Thank you very much, Alan. See you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. Awesome, guys. I always love the energy you put in all the conversation, even you're not together. Sí, aunque no estén juntos, ustedes siempre le ponen sazón a sus conversaciones.
Every day, every night.
Yes, that's the attitude, guys. That's how you should do everything in life. Good. So I enjoy. It's good to hear the good news of Pedrito. Just one thing, Pedrito. Por ahí le dijiste, no me vas a creer, no? You couldn't believe it. You can't believe it. El couldn't es para el pasado. ¿Sí? No me podrías creer, estás diciendo. Y creo que tú querías decir, no me vas a creer, ¿no? You won't believe this or you can't believe this.
Yeah.
Por ahí búscale la frase.
Sí, yeah, I couldn't believe it.
Ajá, no sé cuál de los dos dijo, no me acuerdo si fue Alan o fue Pedrito.
Pedro.
Y algo más por ahí, Alan. Pedrito. I will call you. ¿Querías decir?
Te voy el, a... Alan.
Alan, entonces.
I will call you. Really? You got your old job to become a guard.
No, no, ese sí está bien. Luego dijeron, yo te voy a llamar. I heard that. I will, can you? Eso escuché.
Can you? Ah, Pedro.
Ah, sí.
Casi lo último.
Sí, tal vez casi lo último puede ser.
¿Qué querías decir, Pedrito?
I will, o sea, como que... ¿Te llamaré? ¿O ya podría
sí,
llamarte?
Está bien, te voy a llamar. Bien, solo que se escuchó ese call en vez de call como can de poder. ¿Sí? Ahí no, no tiene sentido. Entonces, si dices I will, can you, si yo voy, puedo tú, no, no, no cuadra.
I will call you.
Call you.
Call you.
Muy bien. Call you. Entonces, mucho ojo con la pronunciación.
Yes,
teacher. De ahí, todo lo demás. Awesome. Perfect. Good job, guys. I always...
Good job, va, 7.
Pero, no mentira. No les he pasado todavía la... Tengo ya sus notas de la quiz. Discúlpenme, pero he tenido mucho trabajo esta semana. Ya les subo el Edmodo con las notas y todo.
No, pues,